Hi, welcome friends. I'm really happy to see you in another video. So today our video is login form. So already we have seen one more login form, but it was created only in the buffer itself. The username and the password store in the buffer itself. So there we cannot store more number of username and passwords. So that's the main difficulty in that login form. But here we are using MS Access database for storing our username and password. So that's the difference between these two login forms. Here we can store more number of username and password, and every time the username and password checks in the database, and if the matches, the next form will be shown. The appropriate error message will be thrown. So we move on to this. So before, let me run the program. Let me show you how to create a table for storing a username and password. Already I have created a table for storing username and password. So similar procedure, add in social data manager. I just open my database. So this is my database. Here I have two username and password for sample purpose. So first one is John. Username is John and the password is also John. And the second one which I have is username is Jeeva and the password is 123. Now I'm running my form. So my first username is John. So before that, let me running this form without entering username or password. So if I run this form without any username and password, I am getting error message, enter username and password, because there is no username and password. That's why I throw this message. So now my username is John. If I am typing a wrong password, J-O-H-A-N. So now I am getting error message, enter valid username or password. Okay, right. Sorry. Okay. So if my username and password both are matches, now I am getting a valid password message. So if my second username, I'm checking. So 123 is the password. So again, I'm giving the same message, valid password. And you people have some doubts. The password field is showing the character what I have typed. So instead of that, I have to show stars. So there will be option called pass character. So simply type asterisk. Now we will get asterisk in the password column. Okay, right. Now we move on to the coding part. So here we have used ADODB connections. So how we can import this ADODB connection into this form? So first go to projects. So you will have a references. So in references you have to choose Microsoft ActiveX data object to my library. Okay, then we have to do the form designs. So username, it required a text field, and password required a text field, and the command button for executing this form, right? So first I'm just writing the code behind this command button. Okay, if I click this command button, it will fire, it will checks whether the username is valid or not. Okay, so for that I have to write the click event. So my event name is command underscore click. Okay. So dim is the keyword which is used to create or declare a variable. CN is my variable. Okay, dim is the keyword for declaring a variable. So dim, my variable name is CN, as a new ADODB connection, and dim RS in the its record set. CN is the full form of connection, RS is full form of record set. So dim RS as new ADODB record set. Now I am opening my database. CN is the connection dot open. So this is a JET provider for Microsoft Access. So followed by my database location. I have stored my database in the location of E drive. Login is my folder name. So login.mdb is Microsoft database. So my next line is I'm extracting my table over here. So RS record set dot open equal to select star from its SQL query. Select star from user is my table name. So where username equal to text one dot text. So text one is my first field. Okay, text one is my first field. Okay, so the plus symbol is indicates I am using trim function. So CN is my connection, and then AD open optimistics and AD lock optimistics. So followed by I am using if condition. If my text box one dot text equal to double quotes, it's nothing, there is nothing in the text box one as well as text box two, it clears, then it will pop up a message, enter your username and password. Else if RS of password dot value, so this password is stored in my database, RS of password dot value equal to text two dot text, so it matches the text which is in the text two box as well as password field. Okay, if both are matches, it will pop up a message valid password. Else it pop up a message box, enter valid and valid username and password. Then it clears the text field one and text field two. Then it will, so once this if case, if conditions are executed, then the database is closed. Okay, so this is the coding. Now hope you understand. So once again I am running this program. So Jiva, okay, password is 123. So this is what creating a login form using a MS Access database. Now this is very clear to you. Okay, thank you once again. See you in a different video. So keep supporting. Thank you all. Thank you.